This place where you now stand is the Golden Land, but evil power turned it into the Dark World. Even right there it says, this was the Golden Land corrupted. But no, Link Between Worlds says, this place looks exactly like Dark World, has the same music as Dark World, but it's not Dark World. Full of evil creatures and dangerous traps. Is that so? I haven't watched He-Man in at least 15 years and paid attention to Mumra's voice. So, wait, Mumra, He-Man, fucking Thundercats, whatever. The point still stands, I don't remember what the character's voice sounds like. Yeah, I was thinking Skeletor. Mumra is the Thundercats. And there's a reason why we're coming up here first. And that is the Quake Medallion. And hopefully I can reproduce something that I found on my practice run. Because it was hysterical. Let's play. Take this and go away! Defeats very few enemies, actually, text box. It turns them into weird things. Alright. And if... No! I don't know what I did, but the last time I was able to dash right here, and this block I would actually fall into as if it was water. I really wish I could fucking reproduce it, because that was fucking weird. Are you sure this is specifically Skeletor? He-Man is the form. I'm trying to think where Ashen said that. Ooh, hey! Red Rupee. Not useful, but hey, it's Red Rupee. That's what I'm thinking about. I can get another heart piece. That's actually the easy way to get the third bottle. In terms of, you know, not having to take the biggest detour ever. But if we come down here. Right here, I'm gonna end up right on top of the... Nope. I'm on top of the buzz ball. For a second there, I didn't read Ever Living as Ever Living. I'm like, Ever Luigi? What? There's a fairy fountain here, but. I don't see myself taking 5 hearts of damage in the next screen and a half. But of course, there's fucking dick sacks there. Fucking hit like a truck. Yes, that's right, I called it dick sack. And if we come through here, if you pay attention to where I'm at, we can actually see where Kiki the Monkey appears. And if we take a hit between here and the rest of the way to Dark Palace, Kiki runs off and takes our 10 rupees. And he wants 10 more rupees to join us again. Greedy fucker. Well, you missed most of Light World if that's the case. If we come down here, I think we can get a key. Yep. But that's not all we're going to be doing before we go deep into the dungeon. I'm just coming over here because you can't push that statue. Button around here somewhere. Of course, it's the last one to pick up. Because the other one I don't think has anything under it. Let's hit that because we gotta come over here. Oh wow, I don't want any rupees right now. And we don't need that button at all. That's what I wanted to show you during Eastern Palace. Oh, fuck. Saw the bubble and panicked. So then I saw that bubble and didn't do a damn thing. Nope. So yeah, I'm taking all kinds of retarded hits. Dancing fuckers. We'll follow you left and right, but we'll go opposite you and forward and backward. And just like the eyeball guys from Light World, the red ones can only be hurt with arrows. But the green ones, for whatever reason, can be hurt with your sword. I don't get it either. Right, there's the map. Coming over here with the bug net's a good idea, because there's 3 fairies right here. Let's catch one for our 3rd bottle and top off. You get to live, 3rd fairy. This key. And that does it for this branch of the dungeon. Nah. Voltorb doesn't split when it explodes. That thing's just an asshole. What's the difference, right? And with our 2 keys in hand, we can actually make it 3. Right now there's red and black guys around. Kind of not able to be dealt with. But first things first, before we go much further, is if we do this. Actually, I don't think I needed to do that other side first. But whatever, I did it anyway. So we have this key to come up and grab none other than the big key. And hop down here. I don't think this small key is necessary, but you know what? It's here, we might as well take it. Okay, yeah, we did have to go up that way. Because the other way doesn't have anything on it. So yeah, I'm doing things out of order, just padding the time. You're not here for 100% speedrun anyway. If that's the case, I blew that a long time ago. Okay, we're gonna come up this way. See, the blue ones are nice and easy to kill. It's the red ones that are real bastards. Okay, if we take that. That was way too risky, but it paid off in the end. Actually, we did need that key. And I want to say these little dino fuckers are Dodongos, but hey, bombs that I can't fucking carry. At least in Breath of the Wild, when you can't pick something up, it says your inventory's full, and it closes the chest again. But then again, that's only if a treasure chest is what's going to give you this weapon, shield, or bow. And if you drop something, don't expect to be able to pick it back up if your weapon breaks. Because if you go too far away, things despawn. Or if there's too many things in memory, it'll just start overwriting. Which I think is something they did in the update to stop a duplication glitch. And I'm kind of upset that I won't be able to do. Because there's some really nice, rare weapons. But with this, we can hit these guys, and for the longest time, I think I forgot that you could hit those things while they're flipped with the hammer and kill them instantly. Because I remember in that aforementioned practice run, killing one with the fucking hammer, I'm like, oh hey, I forgot you can do that. Sometimes I think I should just record my practice runs of games that say I know inside out and backwards, just so I can get a reaction shot of things that I forgot. Yo, it really makes me wonder what's in those blue rupee chests. If it's anything like an Ocarina of Time where, you know, the blue rupee chests are an item that you already have. Like a shield. Okay, let's grab a boomerang. Let's come over here because there's hearts. But the path forward is right here. I don't know if you noticed, but these statues here in Dark World are Hylian soldiers. and not the fucking weird Tauren bull things. Oh yeah, that's right, those bastards take two hits. And none of them dropped replacement arrows. But it's okay, I just got 10 here. And I just noticed my money is giddy up. I think you're supposed to talk to Sahasrara to find out about the switch in the eyeball. Which, now that I think about it, I think that puzzle solution is what gave rise to the eyeball switches in Ocarina of Time. Oh, fuck you. And I think that's the last time I have to hit a crystal trap in this dungeon. There are many, many more crystal traps in the game. Now all the stoners in the audience are gonna be like, haha, blaze it with your money. Ha! Your joke is now ruined. Oh, fuck you. Ha! Managed to kill all three of you, you fuckers. Let's come in here. That was a nice little throwback to Zelda 1. And here is Helmasaur. There's two ways to fight him here. There's with the magic hammer, which is infinite, or you could blow off his shield with bombs. Or, you know, blow yourself up. But honestly, I actually prefer to take the shield off with the magic hammer. And from here, you've either got to smack him with your sword in the crystal, or, much easier, with the bow, if he wants to stand still long enough. And hey, that stopped the annoying beeping. Why, when you can't go through the castle gate anymore, it just spits you into Darkwood. Do you understand?
Sure.
May the way of the hero lead to the Triforce. Basically, the arc words of this game.